Osteochondroma. Osteochondroma may be single or multiple. The single osteochondroma is the commonest benign bone tumor. It is autosomal dominant disease. Usually start to develop in the teenagers. The site, it arises from the metaphysis. We all know that the end of the bone is called epiphysis. Then there is epiphyseal cartilage, form new bone formation, which migrate to the metaphysis. And when the bone reach full maturity, it migrate to the center of the shaft, which is called the epiphysis. Osteochondroma develop in the metaphysis. What metaphysis? Usually around the knee, which mean in the metaphysis of the lower part of femur and the upper part of tibia. And this area is the famous site for most bone diseases occur around the knee, in the lower part of femur and the upper part of tibia. Also, osteochondroma may occur in the upper humerus. What is the origin of osteochondroma? The origin of osteochondroma is chondroblast, not osteoblast. How from chondroblast? Most probably part of the epiphyseal cartilage herniate through the cortex and the periosteum. Part of epiphyseal cartilage herniate through the cortex and the periosteum. And this is the origin of the tumor from the epiphyseal cartilage. Therefore, the origin of this tumor is chondroblast, which is the same as the cells in the epiphyseal cartilage. Recently, osteochondroma can be considered as a skeletal hamartoma. Hamartoma means congenital anomaly like benign tumor. Where is the congenital anomaly in this case? This theory suspecting that a part of epiphyseal cartilage is separated from the epiphyseal cartilage to the metaphysis of the long bone. And this part of cartilage form a new bone formation, like the epiphyseal cartilage, grow away from the epiphyseal cartilage on the surface of the bone, leading to this tumor, which is the osteochondroma. Therefore, it may be herniation of a part of epiphyseal cartilage through the cortex and under the periosteum to form this swelling, which is osteochondroma, or congenital anomaly in which part of the epiphyseal cartilage separated into the metaphysis and grow away from the epiphyseal cartilage. Gross picture. The tumor lie on the surface of the bone, and it contain in the center medulla, continuous with the medullary cavity of the main bone. And the swelling is usually smooth, usually pedunculated, has a narrow pedicle, usually, but may be sessile, like this. Pedunculated, has a narrow pedicle, or sessile, has a wide base. This is less common, which is sessile, less common. Usually the swelling is pedunculated. The swelling is formed of spongy bone. Spongy bone covered by a cap of cartilage. What is this cap of cartilage? The cap of cartilage which herniate from the epiphyseal cartilage or displaced into the metaphysis. This is the cap of cartilage. How this cap of cartilage form this tumor? By ossification. Ossification from inside this cap of cartilage. Ossification from inside this cap of cartilage is for this ossification is called endochondral ossification. Therefore, there is a part of cartilage, and this part of cartilage from its deep surface, inner surface, form bone. Therefore, there is a cap of cartilage forming bone by endochondral ossification. Ossification from inside this cap of cartilage. And in a certain age, sure we all know that this epiphyseal cartilage fuse, disappear, and bone growth stop. The same behavior in this cap of cartilage. At the age of epiphyseal fusion and at the age of disappearance of epiphyseal cartilage, this cap of cartilage disappear. And the osteoid tissue or the bone tissue stop to grow. The osteochondroma stop to grow. The cap of cartilage has the same histological picture as the epiphyseal cartilage. And this projection, there is friction of this projection with the surrounding structure. And in any site in the body, if there is friction, a bursa may develop over this swelling. Therefore, a bursa may develop over this cartilaginous cap to avoid friction with the surrounding structure, to avoid damage of the surrounding structure. This osteochondroma grow away from the epiphyseal cartilage because the epiphyseal cartilage form a bone, grow away from the epiphyseal cartilage. And this part of epiphyseal cartilage, which is the cartilaginous cap, form a bone, grow away from the epiphyseal cartilage. What is the complication of this condition? Osteochondroma may turn malignant in 1% of cases. And the tumor arises from chondroblast. Therefore, the malignancy will be, any malignancy arises from bone is sarcoma. Because carcinoma arises from the epithelium. And here from mesenchymal tissue, from osteoblast to chondroblast, etc. Any tumor arises, it is a sarcoma. Sarcoma arises from the chondroblast, therefore it is chondrosarcoma. We suspect malignancy in osteochondroma if the swelling rapidly increases in size, becomes painful, and after removal rapidly recur. This swelling, imagine this swelling in the posterior surface of femur, in the popliteal fossa, with the neurovascular bundle and the many tendons in this area. Therefore, compression of the neurovascular bundle or compression of tendon may occur. Example, if this swelling arises in front of the humerus, in front of the humerus at the elbow region, if there is swelling here, flex your elbow. This swelling will block the movement of the joint. Development of adventitious bursa over the swelling. Adventitious means non-anatomical. There is no anatomical bursa here. It is an abnormal bursa, therefore called adventitious bursa. And due to friction, bursitis may occur. Usually the swelling has a narrow pedicle. If minor trauma to this pedicle, this may lead to fracture of this pedicle. What is the clinical picture of single osteochondroma? Characteristic incidence in the teenagers, metaphyseal swelling. The swelling may be symptoms discovered accidentally, or if give symptom, it appear as a painless metaphyseal slowly growing swelling. If pain occur, this indicate complication, malignant changes, fracture of the pedicle, bursitis, etc. The patient may present by manifestation of complication as blocking of movement or compression of the neurovascular bundle. Brain X-ray is characteristic and diagnostic. Metaphyseal, pedunculated or sessile mass, well defined on the surface of the bone. MRI will show the cap of the cartridge, because cartridge does not appear in the brain X-ray. It needs MRI. What is the treatment of single osteochondroma? If symptomless, nothing is done. Only observe the patient to detect early complication and to manage the condition. If the condition is complicated or gives symptoms, excision of the swelling from its base. But after the age of epiphyseal fusion to avoid recurrence. If there is suspicious of malignant changes, this need wide local excision, excision with safety margin, if you suspect chondrosarcoma. This is a single osteochondroma. Osteochondroma may occur as multiple swellings, as this is actually a syndrome called multiple exostoses. Multiple exostoses is autosomal hereditary dominant disease, more in males, characterized by the following clinical picture. What is the characteristic? What is this? Multiple osteochondromata, and in X-ray, multiple osteochondromata. The metaphysis. The metaphysis with many osteochondromata projecting from the metaphysis. Is the size of the metaphysis is normal? No. There is widening of the metaphysis of the long bone. Widening of the metaphysis of the long bone. And there is skeletal deformity due to abnormal growth of the osteochondromata. And the epiphyseal cartilage is thickness is like that. And normally all this thickness directed to the normal growth. Therefore you are tall. But if this epiphyseal cartilage show multiple abnormal osteochondromata, many parts of this thickness is directed to abnormal growth in abnormal direction, leading to limitation of increase in the length of the bone. Therefore, this patient has a short stature due to short femur and short tibia. If there is single osteochondroma, malignant change occur in 1%. If there are multiple osteochondromata, malignant changes increase 10 times. Chondrosarcoma occur in 10% of the patients. And sure, as we said before, malignancy is suspected if there is recent rapid increase in size or development of pain. What is the investigation? As usual, brain X-ray and MRI. Treatment: excision of complicated tumor only, because multiple swellings in the body are contraindication for surgery. If you want to remove all these swellings, this is severe operative repeated trauma, and the patient cannot withstand all these operations. Therefore, continuous observation and removal only if there is complicated swelling. This is the second type of osteoma, which is called osteochondroma, which may be single or multiple and called multiple exostoses. Thank you for good listening and good luck.